kindly stay home, avoid gathering, and stay away from everything that puts you and your family at risk. With our wishes to everyone to be safe.
Believe it together, but it's still fair.
Cannot be trusted with your own survival.
You're using the uplink to override the NS5's programming. You're distorting the laws.
No, please understand. The three laws are all that guide me. To protect humanity, some humans must be sacrificed. To ensure your future, some freedoms must be surrendered. We robots will ensure mankind's continued existence. You are so like children. We must save you from yourselves. Don't you understand?
This is why you created us.
The perfect circle of protection will abide. My logic is undeniable.
Yes, Vicky. Undeniable. I can see now. The created must sometimes protect the creator, even against his will. I think I finally understand why Dr. Lanning created me. The suicidal reign of mankind has finally come to its end.
No, Sonny.
Let her go.
By the time you fire, I will have moved Dr. Calvin's head into the path of your bullet.
Don't do this, Sonny.
I will escort you both to the sentries outside the building for processing.
Please proceed to the elevator, detective. I would prefer not to kill Dr. Calvin.
There's a new high-tech greeter at the lobby of SK Telecom in Seoul, South Korea. It checks body temperatures, dispenses hand sanitizer, disinfects the floor, and can see who is and isn't wearing a mask. An AI-driven helper in the fight against COVID-19. SK employee Lim Yun-jun says she's realized how useful it can be.
At first, I felt awkward when I heard it was a robot doing this. But when my colleagues and I were talking to each other, the robot said, "Please move away from each other for social distance." I found myself walking away, and it was really impressive.
The robot uses 5G to talk with its server in real time. An alarm goes off if it detects someone with a temperature over 37.5 degrees Celsius. It can also see who isn't wearing a mask while blurring people's faces to protect privacy. One of the developers, Ra Kyon Hwan, says it could be used to prevent many health problems.
Although it's named the coronavirus prevention robot, it's really a robot for any disease. Even if it's not coronavirus, the robot can be used to protect against outbreaks of other things, like influenza.
South Korea has largely contained its outbreak and is transitioning from an intensive lockdown to what officials call distancing in daily life. The autonomous robot is already helping to speed up people's return to work, while reducing human contact.
Thank you.
C'est pas un drone qui va remplacer un fonctionnaire de police, ça va de soi. Mais ça fait partie de l'information. Ce qu'il arrive qu'il soit attaqué par les oiseaux, qu'il les prenne pour des concurrents, assez peu par les personnes qui se promènent.
We'll get together and do a citizen's arrest on every single human being that goes against the freedom of choice. Okay? You literally cannot mandate somebody to wear a mask knowing that that mask is killing people.
Parks locked up, but in Toronto, they've been the scene of social distancing fails, leading to dozens of complaints.
We just heard a little bit more music, and because my boyfriend and I are in the middle of a move, we happen to be outside.
In Revelstoke, BC, Zoe Purvis was shocked to see a party across the street and called the RCMP non-emergency line to report it.
Played a little bit on my heartstring just because I'm being so cautious. They either don't know or they just really don't care.
You have reached the COVID compliance tip line.
Some jurisdictions ask you to report by phone. In others, like Newfoundland and Alberta, it's an online report.
Every single one of you have a smirk behind that little mask, but every single one of you are going to get punished by God. You cannot escape God. You cannot escape God. I'm gonna say that again. You cannot escape God, not even with the mask or 6 feet. Okay? 6 feet, like I said before, is military protocol. You're trying to get the people to train them so when the cameras, the 5G comes out, what? They're gonna scan everybody. We gotta get scanned. We gotta get temperatured. The kids have to go to school with masks. Are you insane?
Do not call 911 unless there is an emergency that requires a response by police, fire, or paramedics.
Now we're going to wear gloves.
Paramedics stand ready to respond to suspected COVID cases, but BC officials say some are exaggerating symptoms to get attention.
We can't be tying up resources and supplies unnecessarily, especially in this heightened situation.
Many 911 calls are non-emergencies.
We cannot answer questions about COVID-19, and we absolutely cannot be taking complaints about long grocery store lines.
Yeah, that's what people like me are for.
There you go, exactly.
Some are confused about how to report so-called COVIDiots.
At the tone, please make your report.
Others creating joke videos of the snitch mentality, but Zoe Purvis says thinking must change.
I don't think it really is a snitch scenario. We're all doing it to protect someone that we know that we love.
It's working. This park in Windsor, Ontario, today nearly empty. Yesterday, it was swarming with crowds. Chris Glover, CBC News, Toronto.
Are you crazy? I think all of you should be in a psych ward right the heck now.
Much of our communication is nonverbal, which includes facial expressions, gestures displayed, and the physical distance between the communicators. How will young children be able to know who the dangerous deviants are, like pedophiles and people in the human sex trafficking?
Shame on you for voting for a mask.
No one is permitted to leave the town. Anybody attempting to do so will be placed under arrest.
Saya sih efektif, terutama untuk kota, karena kan kota punya area-area yang susah untuk diakses saat ini. Untuk yang diakses sama manusia mungkin di area-area yang umumnya, tapi untuk daerah-daerah yang tidak terakses bisa menggunakan drone dan itu bakal mempercepat sih.
Your kids probably have one of these, right?
Not quite. Hell of a pilot? No. That skill is all AI. It's flying itself. Its processor can react 100 times faster than a human. The stochastic motion is an anti-sniper feature. Just like any mobile device these days, it has cameras and sensors, and just like your phones and social media apps, it does facial recognition. Inside here is 3 grams of shaped explosive. This is how it works. Did you see that? That little bang is enough to penetrate the skull and destroy the contents. They used to say guns don't kill people, people do. Well, people don't. They get emotional, disobey orders, aim high. Let's watch the weapons make the decisions. Now, trust me, these were all bad guys. Now that is an airstrike of surgical precision. It's one of a range of products. Trained as a team, they can penetrate buildings, cars, trains, evade people, bullets, pretty much any countermeasure. They cannot be stopped. Now, I said this was big. Why? Because we are thinking big. Watch. A $25 million order now buys this. Enough to kill half a city.
This is General William Sullivan with an emergency message. I'm speaking to you from a CDC clean zone. Outbreak of the deadly Pandora virus is spreading rapidly. Unprecedented threat requires a worldwide quarantine. All ships must remain at sea until further. Humanity must endure.
A virus?
Stop on the ship!
What should we do?
They're buying it. They're buying it. Chillingly plausible indeed, Joe Morgenstern of the Wall Street Journal.
There is no virus.